So if she can just gently get her in and put her down and then walk away, then we. Exactly. So she might. She's basically one that you get it in quick and then you back away, right? She's not, you know, dragging her around the playground, forcing her to interact or anything like that. But to let her sit in there, she didn't look like she was entering on her own accord. So if she sits in there, I mean, she's not getting the money.
Right.
She's just behind the fence.
Okay. So if a dog is resistant to go in because they're scared, we don't decide, okay, another day and take them back. You put them in here because they need to learn.
It's all up to the group leader.
Okay.
Totally up to the group leader.
Okay.
But yeah, so these girls, they do play group most, and I'll let you know, they do play group mostly for evaluation purposes. So they need to know. They need to know, is this dog going to get along with other dogs? Is this dog, how is it with other dogs? So they're going to try to get the information as safely as possible, as much as they can. When you guys do it, if you feel like she's super shy, and I mean, these guys are pretty calm, but if it was like a crazy rough and rowdy group, you just might be like, nah, you know, she's not right for this group. But obviously these two are not bothering her at all, so this is actually probably the right group for her to join and to start to learn. You know, dogs are okay.
Might make a difference too to the eight of us watching today.
There's a lot,
like,
yeah.
A couple of people walking by.
Right. So that's what I mentioned. You have no idea why she's scared. She might, it might not be the dogs at all. It might be that there's seven people watching her, that, you know, there's crazy noises going on in there. Oh, look at this fancy playground.
I know.
That's
more
boring.
So do your thing. Sometimes playgroups are boring. Honestly, I like the boring ones.
Yeah.
I mean, I like the playful ones too. That's something too. You'll get really good at body blocking. That's where you do the blocking and stuff. You scoot yourself out. I like the boring ones because, you know, less chance of things happening.
And they're still socializing because they see
right.
each other.
Right, exactly.
And they're out of their kennels.
Yeah, so that's good.
And so that's a real big thing. So this dog is just standing here, right? It's out of its kennel. It's only been a couple minutes. She's probably going to be here 10, 15 minutes, something like that. But do you see how much she has to think about? How many things she has to think about? She has to look at this. She has to navigate a social situation right now. The dog's sniffing her. There's people behind her. This is so much mental stimulation that she's not going to need a walk. She's probably going to be exhausted after 15 minutes of this because this is all new and interesting and different. So it's just super beneficial for her.
Not to mention all the smells.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've read that place and there's so much just smelling, how much energy that takes.
Right.
What was her name again?
Which one?
The black one?
This one, Alicia.
Alicia.
Spelled leash.
Oh.
Oh, I know her.
Alicia. Alicia.
Did you do that?
No, she came in with that name.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it wasn't our pettiness.
That's pretty cool, Alicia. Okay. Yeah, she's been there like 25 days.
Yeah.
I didn't recognize her, I know her.
Yeah.
But in her kennel, a black dog in the tent.
I think she's a confiscate too.
Look at her.
Yeah, she was a confiscate, so she's.
So she was a confiscation.
She was a confiscation, so not always, but that means they're typically here a little bit longer.
This one?
Yeah.
So she's been here like 300 socialized.
Oh, it all depends on the confiscation. There are many reasons we confiscate dogs. We actually confiscate, it's called confiscating if the owner dies. If the owner just passes away, if we have to take possession of the dog. The dogs out from Fort Lauderdale, they're all with our deep depression program. They've never had a lot of human contact. So
they're going to get the rest of them eventually?
Yeah, I think in the next couple days, us and the Humane Society and the rescue group are all going to spread it out. Spread out the love.
Share
the love. There you go.
Is there any way you can test them besides freaking out?
Look at it!
Right? So we don't have the ability to do it right now with our facility.
Maybe one day we would.
Right. So I don't even barely have an office. I'm like in a bullpen.
No, I know.
And my story,
I know where you are.
You know, yeah. So basically, it's once I actually get an area that can be a quiet space, then you have to find a cat that can tolerate it and is not going to be freaked out.
Kind of fit,
you know?
I would be like,
I don't think it would be fine.
No, but you have to go in the restroom. You can't just.
Boy, they can hold it longer than people.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's like the Energizer Bunny going and going and going.
So you guys, a couple things you'll see. Did you see what Andrea did here at the fence? She used her squirt bottle, she used her body blocking, and that's to keep these dogs in and get that one to fit in, right? So that's where you can use that. What's his name?
Dusty.
So did everybody see the hair on the back of his?
Yeah.
On the back of it? So that's called hackles, and a lot of people get really concerned about hackles. Hackles are actually just a sign of arousal, period. Okay? So the type of arousal can be different for multiple dogs, but it's literally just a sign of arousal. So don't ever take just the hackles, right? Just that snapshot and say, oh, I can't let this dog in, right? Because his hackles were up, probably because he's totally excited. He came in and played out immediately, right? That's where they bent the front. Does anybody know how to play that?
Yeah.
They bent the front down. They keep the butt up. So he's inviting play. Does that mean he'll play the whole time? Not necessarily, but at that moment he's inviting play. So his hackles were just straight arousal. He was just probably excited. And he, I think he's an unneutered male.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he has a year. He's young. He's young, about a year, a year and a half.
Right. So again, age, their status, neutered, spayed, that doesn't matter. Right, we have an unneutered male. I think we have an unneutered female, we think, right, her?
Yeah.
Unspayed.
And Alicia's not spayed either.
And she's not spayed.
Raina?
That one might be spayed. Oh, they will. They like to poop on their leashes. They're good at it. Yes. So again, that status doesn't matter. The only thing is if they're in heat. And if you don't know how to determine whether they're in heat, it's okay. You can still enter them, but you might see a different behavior. You might start to see different behaviors come about, and that's when you'll take a notice. You'll be like, ooh, we might need to take some of this. Yeah. Oh my goodness, girl. She's
and
like,
where do you discard the poop at the end of play yard?
We have a trash can over there. That's currently hiding our holes into our new building. New old building. Old building. So that's interesting. So, what's his name again?
Dusty.
So Dusty's inviting play to Alicia, right?
Oh,
Dusty's
gonna go. Dusty's gonna
So Dusty wants to play with Alicia. Alicia's unsure. Did everybody see that? She's kind of like, oh, I don't know what to do with that yet. Because she's the shyer girl. She maybe hasn't been in a group of dogs before. But Dusty then backed off. So all of that's really appropriate. All of that. He tried to invite it. She was unsure. And he backed off. But then did everybody see what Alicia did after? know? She came back up to it. Okay? So that's teaching her, right? So that's, this is a really beneficial group at the moment for her to come into. So even though she was shy here, we had to lift her in. These are pretty appropriate guys so far. So she's starting to kind of she's so like an unsure little lady, right? Starting to play, but I bet you she's gonna be one of those that plays and then she's like, oh god, what I do, right? So she's not too sure, she's trying, she's seeing what works and what doesn't. Now I'm gonna take a break because I don't know what's going on.
Is this
Green?
Outgoing
one at first,
and now
yeah,
she's kind of
to watch.
Right?
Is Dusty rough and rowdy style?
You know, I wouldn't say so yet. And the reason I wouldn't say so yet is he might be able to adapt to different play styles because he is trying to play Val Runaway too.
Yeah.
So do you see that? He might be a push and pull, is what I'm guessing. And, watch your legs and bend your knees, right?
Yay! Alright,
tired dog's coming up.
I'm ganging up on him.
On the grade.
So, yeah, watch your legs and bend your knees in play group. Yeah. Because sometimes they come down. I usually book it to the fence. You know, try not to get taken. But that was really nice. That was a lot of push and pull right there. So that's why I might say he's a more push and pull. But he might be one of those dogs that can adapt to multiple play styles. And a really good thing about that is they push and pull, and now they're all taking a break. They're doing that of their own accord, and that's really, really good. If they didn't take a break, that might be where we say, hey guys, take a break. Because you don't want that sort of thing to escalate. Because it can. They could just run and run and run and run and gang up all on one dog and it just escalates.
Or one dog might be tired and want to take a break.
Exactly. And the
other two are, yeah.
Exactly. So, it's all about, you're in here to kind of mediate. You are mostly in here to allow them to learn, to socialize themselves. So a lot of the stuff we'll let them do and let them teach each other. But sometimes you need to be there to help you. But, I mean, huge difference in Alicia, right? Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, that was an awesome choice by Jamie and Andrea there. Yes, let's lift her and get her in there and just let's get and see. Because now she's coming out of it. She's just standing on it. Nope, fine. And you'll notice sometimes we take a lot of photo, video, a lot of stuff together as well. And that's just to help us media and marketing.
What was the name of the gray one again?
Rain.
Rain.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
I thought Dusty was going to interact with her a little bit.
Somebody mentioned earlier, well, I thought Alicia might be the one who would be engaging in play. She might not be a push and pull, so a lot of this is push and pull. You'll even see when Dusty tried to get Alicia to play, he literally pushed her with his paw, right? And she doesn't really seem to know what that is. So she just might not be as compatible with this chasing behavior.
Do they ever change their style?
Yes.
Over time?
So your style changers tend to be your neutrals, and those are the ones I love. Your neutrals are like your anchors in playgroup. They don't react to dogs. They don't escalate. They don't overcorrect. They don't react to corrections appropriately. They'll change their play style. Apex was my guy. He could sit here in a gentle and dainty group, and he would just chill, do nothing. He would lay down, and he would do his thing. Do you want your squirt bottle? I think I stole it. Sorry. He would just do his thing and chill. And then you throw him in a rough and rowdy, and he'd be like, all right. And he would rough and rowdy and play with everybody. And then you throw him in with a push and pull, and he'd be like, all right. And he would go and run around and push and pull, right? So your style changers, yeah, tend to be your vehicles. Those are the ones we really like.
All right, guys, time to gang up on Dusty.
So yeah, Dusty's
Rainy doesn't like it.
He's trying to get her to play. As Andrea just mentioned right now, she gave a little correction. Very, very minute. You guys might not have heard it. It was just a little grumble. Just a little grumble. She didn't snap. She didn't do anything. And he was like, okay. You know? He just seems like a young dude that's just trying to play with anybody. And that's really good. You want to watch her too. She might overcorrect in that sort of situation. But she did it.
I think I'm done with
her. Yeah. So you're watching that behavior. So you said Ray doesn't like her.
She's not enough.
Somebody said Ray doesn't like her. I still need to see if they're going to correct her that sort of thing. Right? So we still allow that behavior to go. We still allow the dogs to tell each other when they've had enough, right?
Okay.
How's done with that, Hammers?
How are you?
Like, I barely have breath to talk to you at all. So we still want to let the dogs tell each other, right? We want to let her tell him though, and see if he responds to that. Because he kind of needs to be told, right? Mm-hmm. A little bit.
Right.
Kind of use a little correction here. But after that little rampage, right? She's taking time out.
So there's a time out.
She was back in the corner, and it's just for her benefit. So we want to take her out on a positive note. You did great at playgroup. You handled it great. Tanya, you can take your bike now. You can go back to your account, okay? So it's not a punishment at all. If we left her in here too long, that would turn into another punishment. Right? We don't want to push her into vaping or any problem. Right? So you can start to see her demeanor change, her tail kind of went down, and that sort of thing. If we left her in here, it's all speculation, but she might react differently. Let's end her on a positive. Good job, girl. You're good with other dogs. We don't want to force you to not by keeping you up. Right. And what's the question?
Oh, Touche.
Touche. Touche's been here just as long, but see her body language? Totally different. Right? She's loose. She's engaging in play. She's climbing in the pool. So she's been here in here just as long as Rain, but she doesn't need to go out. She doesn't need a break because she's doing fine, right? In another 5 minutes, she might be done and need her break. Or if another dog comes in that they don't get along well, she might be.
Hello.
I love that I messed up in it. Touche, she might be more of a rough and round. Because see how she tossed him over and started to like mouth the neck and stuff like that? So she might be more of a rough and rowdy, and he might be more of a push and pull, but they're getting along pretty well. He tolerated that great. He flipped over and was like, okay, right? And remember, she was the one earlier that flipped under rain and wanted to play like that. So again, I wouldn't necessarily label her immediately. The only one I'd be labeling is for sure, Dusty. He's totally pushing ball. He really likes to chase. He'd be able to adapt, but that's his preferred play style. Yeah.
So really likes using those front paws.
Yeah, but see how she mouths more? Yeah. So she might be a little more of that rough and round.
I'm so excited about Alicia.
Yeah, I
want to
put Alicia
and
Dusty
together. Yeah. So Alicia just like hides at the back of the pen and all that stuff. So that was pretty cool, right? Use it to your advantage. They're all distracted doing their thing. Bring the dog in real quick.
Oh, thank you first.
Oh, right on the
right
leash.
On the
leash. Yeah. Yeah. I would probably call her a little rough and rowdy.
Oh.
Oh, guys. Just don't put your head in it, right? There you go. Okay.
Oh, no, I'm
drinking water. Oh. Who's this?
Percy. Percy. Been here a while. He got attacked by
a rooster.
Rooster? Aww.
You laugh at him.
Poor guy.
Poultry.
Oh. They didn't eat him.
And sometimes you'll get dogs who really go like people a little bit more than dogs. And they'll really try to engage you, and it's the hardest thing ever,
yeah.
But you can't engage in them. What I usually do, I try to keep in the back of my mind, is walk away, walk away, walk away. I don't want dogs playing at my feet either, because if something were to happen, and my feet happen to be there, I'm probably going to get in the middle of it. So I don't like when dogs play around my feet, so I tend to be walking a lot at playgroup and moving away. It gives you a much better visual, too. When you're a step away, you can see better what's going on, too. Sometimes drooling is a sign of stress. Oh, so he's gonna get on and mount. We're gonna see what happens. Remember, watch the dog that's receiving. That was terrible. Alright, so we're gonna, you know, it's all up to the group leader how comfortable she is. You guys might want to squirt him at this point. We might not want to squirt him. He might get off. That was actually really cool to see that this guy will tolerate that and be fine with it. It's also appropriate if he corrects. Appropriate to correct a dog that's around me. The only thing that's not appropriate is an overcorrection, right? So I correct him and I keep going after him. But he could have growled, he could have snapped. That's all fine. Oh, there's a bird out. Okay. I guess he liked it.
Yeah.
So again, he came in nervous. His hackles are still up a little bit. He's got shorter hair, but you can tell his hackles are still up a little bit. That's all arousal.
Oh man, I'm
losing it here, aren't I?
Oh.
Yep. So he's more of a.
Little.
sitting up. He's a little less tense. He's starting to engage a play. He did the play bow. That's right. Dusty's getting dusty.
Mm-hmm.
He made that. Dusty backs off, we're all cool. Okay? But keep an eye on that because it can escalate. That sort of thing can escalate. Dusty came, or Percy came back and play bowed after that. So, you know, are we going to escalate?
Just setting a boundary is basically what they're doing.
Yeah, I mean, corrections are okay. And it might not have been a correction. It might have been he's just a vocal player, you know? But you just learn all this to play. When you're watching all their body language. But at least gives you, my goodness, dude.
I know.
At least gives you information. We try to get the leashes out of the way.
Yeah. So how many playgroups do you typically have on each day?
So, the playgroups that I run, I do a full time week. These girls are doing it every day they're here. So they're doing it Sunday over.
One continuous playgroup
with them
cycle
here. It's usually two. It depends because they have to enter their information. Yeah, so usually they'll do one and they'll take a break, or they need to eat sometimes too. They'll take a lunch.
Can't
I allow
the
them to take
day.
Lunches.
You
expect
them
to
right,
exactly. Breaks. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, see, he's real pushy.
Look at those eyes.
No.
Pump face,
right? Alright. Well, so, and Antonia just chooses to squirt that. Why probably corrected earlier? No. But it doesn't matter. I'm not here to question what she's doing. She's the leader, right? That's why. That's why we have a group leader, because you don't want to, again, in the middle of things happening, be at conflict with each other, right? You want to let them, you know, the group leader decide what they want to do, and to the dogs how they want to. You can always talk later if you have a question. But that's mostly, I've noticed that Touché, Touché seems a little vocal to me. That wasn't a correction, that's more a vocal play. Hey, Alicia? Alicia might be getting vocal too.
Yeah. And that's okay, the play growl and everything.
Oh, yeah. So watch the body language. Can it escalate? Sure. Can it escalate?
Oh.
That's why you have to wash.
Oh, Dusty.
Alicia.
that's all broken. Just wash the dog. We'll wash the dog that's receiving it. So apparently it's just me.
He's over it.
He has more.
He's feeling pretty darn well. But he is, his tail's going under a little bit. He might need a break, sort of thing.
I was wondering about Puka.
Puka
is Puka push and pull. Do you know who I'm talking about?
I'm trying to think if I've had her in play group.
Okay.
I want to say I have. I'd have to look back. Let's see, because I can't remember. You also notice, guys. You notice that the girls have taken a break on bringing dogs in. I'm kind of guessing at their philosophy on that, but most likely because this is a really good group and they're letting these dogs get that appropriate, nice energy out. Sometimes you'll notice you'll bring a dog into play group and the whole play group will change. The whole demeanor will change just because of one dog. Or you have a whole group going and you take one dog out and the whole demeanor changes and they all loosen up and that sort of thing. So this is a really good group. They're all comfortable and loose with each other. At the moment, again, things can always escalate.
But it's good to give them that appropriate socialization and energy, right?
Okay, so
yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think
I it's 3:30 and I have another.
You got it. Thanks. So if it's 3:30, you guys are free to go.
Those guys really enjoy each other's company. So when do you guys do this? Any special time in the afternoon?
No, because our days change so dramatically as we get tasked to do other things randomly.
Yeah.
We help out.
I understand.
So, yeah, we still haven't gotten our schedule down fully with it all.
When do you usually say, okay, is there a usual time, like 5 o'clock, you say, or, you know, that you shut down, or you say?
Our shift ends at 5. So okay. We usually try, if we do afternoon groups, stop by 4 so we can do all the paperwork.
I see.
So we want to input everything before we
leave. I love this. I love to see the dogs play. And so,
that's what we try to before 4, but we don't have any specifics yet what time, so. But we're getting there, where we get a good schedule eventually.
Oh, yes.
Especially this little one, it's just adorable.
Yeah, do you put the little ones in with the big ones? Not.
She's probably the smallest I would go.
Okay.
We haven't been doing the small dog groups because I want to keep it separate. But usually the volunteers that really like the small dogs do that.
I see.
You don't want to risk it.
I see. Because I have a bunch of little dogs and I would. And I want to take them to play yards at parks and stuff like that. But then, you know, there's a lot of big dogs, and so...
Yeah, it just depends on how they do. I mean, I take my dogs to parks, like the, of course, this one right here, and then the one by Costa Cotera. And there's some small dogs that go in, and they just know how to handle the big dog energy and scare them, actually, you know?
Yeah.
They intimidate them. Little Bostons. And there's a little French Bulldog.
Cal, that one's mine. Huh? Seriously, I'm bringing my dog back up to do a meet and greet.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I mean, sorry, at a dog park.
Oh.
Yeah, he's already owned. Don't worry. Which one are you?
Mariposa.
She's sweet.
Yeah, well, I...